Thank you, Karen. Well, it's been a very full day. Many of you have sat for a very long time, and we appreciate that. I just have a few closing remarks. I want to thank Chris and Beth and Michelle for your time and your service and commitment to children and families in the city and in the state, and the collaborative nature of our work goes on. And I want to mention a few things that I think we'll take away, or hopefully take away, from our keynote speakers. I think we'll all have a new appreciation for every piece of apple pie that we ever eat in the future. Maybe we'll see more apple pie at various meetings and various gatherings. It's now become the symbol of our work together. I want to really acknowledge Ruby's thoughtful and deep commitment to families who are struggling and who we often perhaps overlook as to how hard it is for them to have access to the programs and services that we talk about so often and with such energy for very, very challenged families. But we forget sometimes, I think, about those hardworking families that are just above all these eligibility levels and what it takes for them to raise their children and give them a full experience. The other thing that Ruby said, I think, that really matters and resonates is that this is a long march. And I think that in Illinois, in terms of early childhood, we've all got our marching boots on, and maybe we're dressed and ready to go, and we have a sense of where we're marching to, but it's going to take us a very, very long time to get there. And it's through our collaborations and our energy and people's innovations and vision that we will continue to revitalize ourselves and pass the baton to those who come up with new energy and ideas and keep marching. And we're going to get there. We don't know when, but we're going to make it. I want to go back to something I think, Michelle, you said about this expansion, if you will, of thinking about early childhood beyond five. And I know many of you and us at Voices have some fears, probably, complicated feelings about if we expand this early childhood definition to third grade, what's going to happen to the resources, those precious early childhood resources, and are we going to forget about birth to three as we focus on preschool through third grade and those kinds of deep, important questions and fears. And I think part of the answer is we have to make the commitment not to take away from one in order to serve the other, is one part of it. And the other part is to see it as a really important continuum, and each builds on the other, and the success of each as the child ages depends on what happened in the earlier period of time, and it behooves all of us to not let anybody forget about that and not let anybody shift the focus away from, but make this a process of addition and not substitution or subtraction.
So I'm really glad you brought that up. I because it's there. I think it's one of the elephants in the room. And we want to name it and recognize it and know that it's all important. I want to talk for a minute about
what happens next. This summit for us at Voices is really a beginning. It's by no means an end or an event in and of itself. It's really a sort of a phase one marker. We're ending the phase one period of time that we've spent the last couple of years really thinking and learning and talking about expanding this concept up through third grade. So there's a lot more to learn, certainly for us, and hopefully everybody here meeting today feels somewhat stretched in some way about something they learned or something they heard, and we're all in this journey together, and it is an exploration. So in terms of short-term next steps, we would like to ask you, you all have a blue evaluation form, which it really isn't. It's more of a form about who you are and what you're thinking about as you leave here and what you'd like to see happen next. A couple of short-term things we plan to do is we will get to all of you some sort of a summary of today's proceedings, and we'll share that with everyone and post it on the web. We encourage you again to go to the website, which we are building as we go, and we will continue to be adding to that, and it's easy to find on our webpage. It's a bright yellow box with graded 8, and it's very easy to navigate the web. But if you would think as you fill out your blue forms, we would like to convene a discussion in December growing out of today. And if you're interested in participating in some sort of a discussion about reflections on today and possible next steps, we would encourage you to fill it out on your form and just say, give us your name and your contact information again, and also say you'd like to participate. And if you have a particular area of interest, we'd like you to make note of that. If you want to write on the back of the blue sheet, that's fine. I'd like to thank our staff. The staff that put today together, it is always a lot of work behind the scenes, as anyone who ever does this knows. And I want to particularly recognize our Birthday 8 team, Joan Vitale, who's been in and out, was really responsible for this day, and I want to give Joan recognition of that. But I also want to recognize the rest of the Birthday 8 team at Voices, Madeline James, Jessica Roberts, Paula Corbin Halpern, and Melissa Mahan, our communications guru at Voices. So as you leave here, I hope you've been energized. I hope you've had at least one brief aha moment, if not more. Stay in touch with us and continue all the work that I think everyone in this room is contributing to one another, even if you don't know each other and you don't know what that person over there is doing, that we're all part of this long march. Thank you.